Hey everyone, one of the first things I did after moving house last year was ensure that I had gigabit networking everywhere. This is partly due to nerdy pride on my part, but it's also because I have lots of large video files, and anything below gigabit speeds is just way too slow. However, I've been having an annoying issue for the past 9 months. This PC's network speeds suddenly become really slow. They cap to just 100 megabits per second. This might not sound too bad, but when you move in the massive 20 gig files around, it is pretty frustrating. Thankfully though, I think that I fixed this issue, finally, and spoiler alert, this isn't purely a hardware issue, it can actually be a bug within Windows 2. So the first thing you should try is to turn it off and back on again. Yes, I know that that's an annoying tip, but sometimes I rebooted my PC, or my network switch, or both, and then the network speed went back up to 1 gigabit. Removing the Ethernet cable and putting it straight back in again also helps sometimes. So that's good, but unfortunately it's often reverted back to 100 meg speed after a few days or a few hours. And so this certainly wasn't a permanent fix, meaning that something else was going wrong along the network chain. And that's the difficult thing about this particular problem. You're likely to have many hops between your ISP's modem and your actual PC. In my case, I had a Enumerator router, then a network switch, then another network switch, and finally my desktop PC. There's also multiple Ethernet cables here too, along with RJ45 wall jacks that I plug my Ethernet cables into. If any of these had a fault, I could be capped at just 100 meg speeds. So tracking down the exact cause of this problem can be difficult because it's not exactly practical to go out and buy a new Enumerator router or hundreds of pounds worth of new network cable, of course. That's why turning things off and on again can help, because if the problem is with a single router or cable, it can help you isolate the fault. But if that doesn't work, the second thing I'd probably check is the network settings within Windows itself. Whether you connect to your internet with an Ethernet cable or over Wi-Fi, you should check what the link speed is. This is the speed that your computer's network is actually running at. To check this, click the network icon in the bottom right tray, select the network and click on the I icon. This will open a network properties box and you should scroll down until you see the link speed option. This is the speed your computer has negotiated with your router or your network switch. So if this is below the speeds that you were expecting, then the problem might be due to a Windows issue. Of course, it can also be due to a bad cable or a few other hardware problems which I'll discuss in a minute, but let's look at the Windows settings in more detail first. Search for View Network Connections and right-click on the active network, basically the one you're connected to. This would probably be Ethernet if you're using a network cable, or Wi-Fi if you connect to a wireless router. Click Properties, Configure, and then Advanced. If you're on Ethernet, scroll down to Speed and Duplex and ensure that Auto Negotiation is selected. If it says 100 megabits per second, for example, then that's why your speeds are automatically being capped down. The Auto option is probably best here, however, if you instead use Wi-Fi, you'll probably want the two channel widths to be set to auto and ensure the fat channel intolerant is disabled. You might also want to decrease roaming aggressiveness to lowest or medium low, because medium can sometimes cause issues. Finally, move on over to the power management tab at the top. Ensure that the power saving option is unticked, otherwise this might be causing you problems too. You should then restart your computer and see whether the problem is resolved. So that takes care of the basic network settings within Windows, and while there are some other parts of Windows that might be causing issues, I want to discuss the next most likely cause. So in order to get gigabit speeds, all of the Ethernet cables should be in good working order, and they should be at least Cat 5e or upwards, basically Cat 6 or Cat 7. Simple Cat 5 cable is not sufficient. If you connect over Wi-Fi, you might be thinking, well, this doesn't apply to me, but it's likely that at least one Ethernet cable is in your house, maybe for connecting your ISP supply to your router, for example. In my case, there's actually 5 Ethernet cables, one from my modem to my Enumerator router, then another from my router to my network switch. The switch then connects to a wall patch, so there's then a 4th cable running inside my walls to get to this study. I then plug a 5th Ethernet cable in at my study over there and connect this to my PC. If any of these cables are damaged, however, I immediately get 100 megabit speeds. That's because Ethernet CAT cables have 8 wires inside of them, and to achieve gigabit speed, every single wire must be unbroken and terminated correctly at the plug end. So if a chair rolled over an Ethernet cable and damaged a single wire, I'd then get 100 meg speeds. One time I actually purchased a Cat5e cable in a shop and it wasn't terminated correctly, only 4 of the 8 wires were connected at the end. This meant that the cable was never able to achieve the gigabit speeds that it advertised. In terms of how to fix this, you can either get an Ethernet tester which can show you whether any of the wires are badly terminated, or you could just try swapping out each cable one at a time and see whether the link speed then goes back up to gigabit or whatever you were hoping for. And this brings me onto the 4th potential issue here, and it's a bad RJ45 wall patch. This is the wall socket that you plug your Ethernet cables into, and this is what it looks like behind it. While it's rare for one of these to fail, If one of the 8 terminal connections became loose, this would again result in you only getting 100 megabit speeds. So if you're able to, it could be worth gently pulling these out of the wall to actually rule out any loose connections. The fifth cause of slower than expected connection speeds, though, is your switch or your router, especially if you've ever changed the settings within the management console. Sometimes your router allows you to limit the bandwidth of a particular device, for example, and you might have done this years ago and then forgot about it. So it's worth double checking all of the settings. Equally, enabling settings like QoS and parental control can have an impact too. They can slow things down. So it might be worth restoring some of the default values and seeing whether this helps. If not, in rare cases, the switch or the router itself could be faulty. Everything fails after all, and even a bad Ethernet port could limit your computer's connection speeds. So if you're using Ethernet, try moving the cable to a different port on the switch or the router. Equally, you could try plugging your computer directly into the ISP's modem and see whether the problem persists then. If your connection speeds go back up to gigabit after this, then you have a bad switch or router. However, if your connection speeds are still low even when plugged directly into the ISP's device, you're probably experiencing a bug within Windows itself. I like Windows 11 overall, but I swear there has more networking bugs compared to previous versions of Windows. So the sixth thing I would try is to ensure that the network card's drivers are updated. To do this, open Device Manager and expand out Network Adapters. If you connect over Wi-Fi, you'll probably see an entry that says Intel Wireless or similar. If you use Ethernet, you'll probably see words like Realtek, PCI Express or GBE, something like that. Right-click on the entry and select Update Driver. If you're able to, I'd also try updating the motherboard's BIOS. Sometimes these are handled through Windows updates, especially if you have a main brand laptop. But if you have a custom build desktop, for example, it's likely you need to actually manually follow your motherboard's BIOS update steps. This process, however, can vary a lot, so I'll put some links down in the description for this. The seventh cause here is an annoying one. One day I enabled Hyper-V, or I downloaded VirtualBox, but I can't remember which, but I started getting 100 meg speeds immediately after installing virtualization. So I dug into things a bit, and I noticed that my PC had a bunch of extra network interfaces added within the network connection section of Windows. That's fairly normal for virtualization, of course, but Windows was randomly connecting to these networks, and that's when I had the slower networking speeds. Then it switched back to the normal network automatically, and I went back up to gigabit speed, which was odd and annoying. So I ended up just disabling Windows virtualization features because I didn't really need them. But obviously, if you really need to run VMs, then you probably need to do some extra debugging. However, there certainly does seem to be some annoying interplay here between recent Windows versions and virtualization, at least in my case. So I had replaced my fault Ethernet cables and disabled virtualization, and all was well in the world, right? Well, it was for many months. But a few weeks ago, my PC started getting 100 megabit speeds again. As a result, I threw my PC out of the window and I bought a new one. Kidding. I did some more digging and I found a weird entry within Device Manager that was related to my HP printer. Some people online say this device can cause networking clashes, and so I disabled it and immediately went back up to gigabit link speeds. Woohoo! I don't really know why this entry appeared, nor why it nuked my network speeds, to be honest, but disabling it definitely worked for me. As a general suggestion, if you suspect that a bug within Windows is causing you networking issues, you should boot up into safe mode with networking and see where your link speeds are there. If everything looks good in safe mode, then one of the installed programs or drivers is your culprit and you may need to reinstall or reconfigure it. If you're still having issues though, the ninth option is to just look at replacing the device you're using to connect to the internet. It might be that your computer has a separate Wi-Fi card in it, and so simply replacing that card with a new one might help fix the issue. Or if you're relying on your motherboard's built-in Ethernet or Wi-Fi, buying a separate card like this 10 gig PCI Express card can also help you out. And I finally have a home network that I'm proud of, and I no longer experience these annoying speed drop issues, which is a relief. I show off my home network setup in another video if you wanted to check that out, and I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.